Jesus of praise. Let's sing this together.
When all I see is a battle, you see my victory. When all I see is a mountain, you see a mountain move. And as I walk through the shadow, your love surrounds me.
Spirit was moving over the water. Spirit, come over us. Come rest on Holy Spirit, Spirit of the living God, this morning I just pray over this place, every person in this room, whoever will eventually see this, that you would give us a fresh filling, that you would have your way in our hearts this morning, Lord. We want to be attached to you. We want to be following you. We want to be a part of what you're doing, Lord. So would you move right now? Would you move in our hearts? We call on your name. Spirit of the living God, fill us up. We love you. It's in your name I pray, Jesus. Amen, amen. Welcome in day 5 to 21 days of prayer. Come on in, Cedar Crest Church. So great to have y'all here today. Another great morning. So many people here. It is so good to see you here. You know what I love about what we are doing this week? By the way, my name is Richard Hopkins, and man, it's just an honor to be in this space with you this morning. What I love about what we are doing this week, sharing our word that God has given us individually for 2024, is that you kind of get to hear us preaching. You get to hear what God is preaching to us inside our hearts this morning, right? I mean, it's like, what is God working on within us right now? And so I love that. I love that you get to hear and see that. And hopefully it's working in your hearts when it comes to what does God have in store for you in 2024? You know, over the holidays, I was really wrestling with God, which it actually does happen where you're kind of like brainstorming with God. What is my word? And I kept taking words to God like, hey, what do you think about this? What do you think about this? And I landed on disciple. And that made sense because it was like, well, I work at a church and I want to make disciples. I want to be a disciple. But then I kind of realized like there's something a little unsettling about that word for me because it was definitely outwardly focused. I am a person, just to be quite honest with you, that can be very results driven. I'm like, hey, can we measure that? What can we, you know, can we see what's going on with that? And so disciple, that made sense for me because I could measure like how many people did I get to disciple in 2024 or, you know, are we making disciples at Cedar Crest Church? But that was unsettling. And so over time, it became very clear that was not the word for me, but actually the word that God gave me was abide. The word abide. And that actually looks different than disciple, but there's actually some connection there. I came to realize that I can't be a disciple. I can't make disciples unless I am willing to be abiding in Jesus. And I want to define what I mean by abide. Essentially, abide means to remain. It's like to remain in or to continue in or even to dwell. And so this morning, my word is abide. And I would love to just share with you a passage that, Jesus just lays it out. What's it look like to abide? If you have an NIV Bible, this will read a little differently. I'm using the New King James Version today. This is John 15:4-5. John 15:4-5. Here it is. I guarantee you, you're familiar with it. Abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine. Neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. Man, whew, you can do nothing unless you are abiding in Jesus. Some observations from this passage. The first one is this. When we abide in Jesus, Jesus abides in us. He tells us that. It starts with us. We make a choice to abide, lean in with Jesus. Secondly, Jesus says, I am the vine. Now, in the context of when the disciples were hearing this, they would have actually understood this a little more than us because in the Old Testament, it's all about Israel being the vine. But he says, I am Lord. I am the vine. You are the branches. And so he's making it very, very clear that he is the source. He is the one that we go to. He is the one that we remain in. He is the one that we continue in, that we abide in. And then he also says, when we do that, when we abide in him, we will bear much fruit. We will bear much fruit. And he also says, we can't bear fruit unless we abide in him. Now, what is fruit? What is Jesus talking about when he talks about fruit? I think Paul gives us a great example of this, at least a piece of it anyway, in Galatians 5:22. Love, joy, peace, forbearance or patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. I think we'd all agree, man, that sounds like the kind of fruit we want to bear, right? But then there's also a kind of a continuing thing. What is God doing in you? He also does through you with others. It's being a disciple. It's making disciples. It's sharing our faith. See, the point is that making disciples actually flows out of being with Jesus. And what I read when I read these verses, what I actually hear is this: hey, Richard, I need your attention. You're not a human doing. It's not about results. You're not a human doing. You are a human being. Be with me. Remain in me. Abide. Then and only then will you bear much fruit. You cannot give what you don't have. John 15:5. This is the drop the mic moment. He says, apart from me, you can do what? Nothing. Nothing. Tangible example of this. Last week, if you missed First Wednesday last week, man, go back and get it. It is so good. Pastor Van, he talks about inquiring of the Lord. And when you make decisions, just confessing to you, it's very easy to just be impulsive, intuitive. I know what the Bible says. Let me just do it. Right? But inquiring of God, what a great example of what it looks like to abide in Jesus, going to him first, remaining in him. I think it's what Paul means when he talks about praying without ceasing. It's like you're just continuously in the vine with Jesus. You're connected to him as a branch. Man, I'll tell you what, it is so easy to lose sight of that. And I think that's what God has in store for me in 2024, to continue to seek him, to abide in him, to lean in with Jesus. The bottom line is, ministry flows out of being with Jesus. Great picture of that with Martha and Mary, right? Like, so easy to be the Martha running around cleaning a house. I can see the results. But Jesus said, what did he say? He said, only one thing is needed. Only one thing, and that is sitting at the feet of Jesus. I love the song that says, Lord, I need you. Every hour, I need you. That's what it looks like to abide in Jesus. As a branch, man, we are connected directly to the vine this morning through our time with him. And that's what I love about what we're doing in 21 days of prayer. This is exactly what it looks like to abide. In a few minutes, we're gonna go out there and we're gonna spend time being connected in the vine. Final example of what a tangible example of what it looks like to be connected. I love the story of the feeding of the 5,000. Because, you know, the disciples come to Jesus and they're like, man, all we got are these, you know, a few loaves and a few fishes. And, you know, Jesus does a miracle. But he doesn't just do a miracle. He actually does a miracle through the disciples. He starts manufacturing the loaves and the fishes. And he doesn't just give them to the people. All the people are gathered around. But actually, the disciples receive the fishes and the loaves. And then they give them to the people. They're connected to the vine. They're receiving the fishes and the loaves. And then they're able to give what they have received. As I mentioned at the beginning, I'm all about doing things, getting results, what's measurable. But looking ahead in 2024, when it comes to bearing fruit, man, the one thing, only one thing is needed to bear fruit, and that is to abide in Jesus and leaving the results to him. That's my word for 2024. I want to abide in Jesus. Well, as we send you out this morning, I just want to cover a couple of things. We'll be back here this morning at 6:45. And I'd love to just pray for us before we send you out as you're spending time. There's prayer journals out there or prayer manuals. If you haven't gotten one of those yet, make sure you grab one. That is a great resource for you this morning. Let's pray. Father God, thank you so much for your word. Lord, you said, be doers of the word. But then you also said in that preceding passage to humbly receive the word. Lord, we humbly receive what you have for us this morning as we lean in, as we abide in you, as we connect to the I am, the vine. We want to be your branches, Lord. We love you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, have your way in our hearts this morning. And it's in your name I pray, Jesus. Amen.
Yours to God when it's hard. Cause you are Alpha, only the beginning and end. Savior, Messiah, rose of shame. And yours to God is provision. Yours to God is hope. Yours to God is the harvest. Yours to God is overflow. Cause you are Alpha, Omega, beginning and end. Savior and Messiah, rose of shame. When nothing makes sense, you're still God. So I'll build my life on this. That you are who you say you are. You are who you say you are. You are who you say you are. Cause I've seen it and I know. Still God, I don't understand. You're still God, nothing makes sense. You're still God, I'll build my life on this.
back couldn't carry the weight. trouble, but I've seen revival. I've seen peace overcoming the chaos with just one word. And I have walked through the valley of shadows and sang my way through the darkest of nights. I've held on to your every word, and I will survive.
Oh, and through every season, you've been my strength, and with all my heart, I'll trust you, Lord.
Search the world, my head couldn't fill me, man's empty praise and treasures that fade are never enough. And you came along, put me back together. There's nothing better than you.
Jesus Christ, may I Jesus. Just start saying things out loud to him. Worship him. Use your mouth. Come on, right now. Worship him. Lord, we love you. We worship you. We worship you. We put you in first place. Come on, church, out loud. Let me hear you. Just worship Jesus. Just use your mouth to proclaim with your lips that he is Lord. We confess with our mouth that you're Lord right now in Jesus' name, God. We worship you. We look to you. Just say hallelujah. If you don't know what to say, just say hallelujah, hallelujah, over and over again. Lord, we love you. We praise you. We worship you. We give you all glory and all honor in Jesus' name. You're worthy of everything, God. You're worthy of all of our attention, all of our focus. You're worthy of getting up early in the morning to seek your face, Lord. We thank you that you speak to your people. We thank you that we can always call on your name because you're worthy of it, God, and you draw near to us when we do. Thank you for meeting with us in this place. In Jesus' name we pray. All right, we want to get you in groups now, get you praying with one another. I know you feel a little awkward praying to me. You're not praying to me, you're praying to God, but it's okay. You can speak out loud at 6 a.m. in church. Get in groups of 2 to 4 right now. I'm going to give you some other things to pray for with each other. Want to get you praying together. We've had some individual time with Jesus. Now we get to pray and agree with one another. There's power in agreement. When 2 or 3 gather together, he's there. When we agree in his name, he hears our prayers. There's power in that. So we want to make sure that we have an opportunity to do that before you leave today. All right, here's what we're going to do, church. As you know, we've kind of had a theme this week. We've been praying for one another, power in Jesus' name, breakthrough prayers yesterday. Today, I want you to pray for one another's word. Now, some of you may not have a word for the year yet, and if this is your first morning with us, it's okay. Go back and watch Monday on YouTube so you can get an idea about how to get a word, but you can just share with your group, hey, I don't have a word yet, and people can pray for you to get a word from the Lord for the year. But if you've been traveling with us over the next few days and you know what that is to get a word and you've already got a word, I'd love for you to share that with the group that you're praying with and then have that group pray that for you. So if I was praying with Richard this morning, I'd be saying, Lord, bless Richard as he seeks to abide in you. May he abide all day long. May he not be able to do anything other than abide in you. That's those kind of prayers that you want to be praying for each other. Okay, you got it? All right, praying for the word. If they don't have a word, you're praying they get a word. Go for it. I know I'm moving a little fast. Don't worry about it. If you're still praying, just keep praying over one another. It's okay. Just for those that are already kind of wrapping up prayer, I'm going to keep moving us along. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you want to do things in us and through us this year. We thank you that you're speaking individual words to every single person that would ask you for a word to hold on to. Lord, we thank you that you're the good shepherd and that we are your sheep. We are the flock of your pasture, and we can hear your voice. Lord, thank you that you guide us through your word. I pray for those that are still solidifying what you're saying. You would lead them to a scripture to stand on this year, that it would be the thing that they return to over and over again, no matter what they might face. Lord God, I pray that we would live with the vision and the purpose of having a specific word that you've spoken to us, that it would encourage us to go out and to live that word out in front of our family, in front of our coworkers, in front of the folks we go to school with. Lord, everywhere that we go, may we be a living advertisement of that word in Jesus' name. May it not just be kind of a church thing that we look at in our journal when we're in this building, but Lord, may it be something that we take with us to wherever we're doing life, God. We're asking that our faith would go with us and that we would live it out loud wherever we land. We love you, Jesus, and we thank you so much for that. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Okay, again, if you're still praying with one another over your words, that's great. Just keep going. But for those of you that are ready to pray the next thing, the last thing we're going to pray for this morning is I just have a sense that the Lord wants us to go out today as ambassadors. He wants us to be his mouthpiece, literally his hands and his feet, that we would proclaim the goodness of God, the faithfulness of God to others that we encounter. And so what I want you to pray for one another specifically is boldness to share about what God is doing on the inside of you with someone else today. So you might even have in your mind the classes that you're going to go to. If you're a student, you might have in your mind where you're going to work. If you're a stay-at-home mom, maybe you've got a play group. Maybe you know you're going to Chick-fil-A for lunch. And so it's while the kids are in the playpen at Chick-fil-A, you're going to find a coworker and just share Jesus with them today. So whatever that looks like, pray that boldness for one another. And again, I'm not asking you necessarily, if you don't know how to do this, to go out and share your faith and walk somebody through the four points of the gospel, and do you know if you die today if you'd go to heaven? If you know how to do that, great, go for it. But at the very least, that you'd be able to say to someone, hey, you know, Jesus answers prayer, and I was praying this morning, I just feel like God would like to encourage you in this particular way and maybe offer to pray for someone. Pray that kind of boldness and for opportunities to do that today. All right, I think I've given you enough to pray over. Take all that, bring it to the Lord, pray for one another. Let's be bold today in Jesus' name. Just share where you're going to be today, where you're going. That way your group can pray for you. There may even be some spiritual gifts that are coming to life right now. Maybe you're having an impression, a name of somebody, or a picture of a place, or particular clothing that somebody's going to be wearing today, that God would highlight that so that you know, hey, this is the person right here. Those are called words of knowledge. The Holy Spirit will speak to us. Lord, I pray over all my friends that can hear my voice right now, whether they're in this room or whether they're watching this online later today. Lord, this is Gideon's army, and I pray that you would raise them up today, Lord, to be your hands and feet. We ask for boldness in Jesus' name. We believe that what you're doing on the inside of us as individuals and as a church family was never intended just to stay in these walls, but it was intended to be carried out to the highways and to the byways. And we pray that in Jesus' name, wherever we're going today, that we would walk with intentionality, believing believing that you have divine appointments for us, places where we can go and share what you're doing on the inside of us, that we can offer to encourage and pray for other people, that we might have scriptures that we were even meditating on this morning that we could share with someone else. And whether it's our five-year-old that we're getting out the door to school, or whether it's our 55-year-old boss at work, or whoever it might be, Lord Jesus, we're asking for opportunities to share the goodness of who you are with someone else today. So I pray for those appointments. I pray for those opportunities. I pray that you'd make it clear. Lord, I pray again for boldness. I pray that no one would hold back and that everyone would have a smile on their face and love in their heart for you and for others today. Lord, thank you that you're wanting to again speak to us. Thank you that you're wanting to guide us. Thank you that we get to live on this adventure with you. Thank you that we get to be a part of the mission. Thank you that you chose people to be your hands and feet and to be light and darkness. And so as we go out literally into a morning that's still dark and not yet light, I pray that as the sun begins to rise, as we get home and as we get to school and as we get to work, I pray that even the sun coming up over the horizon would remind us that we're called to be light, a city set on a hill, in Jesus' name. We thank you for it, God. And everybody said, amen. God bless you guys. Thanks for being here. We'll see you Friday at 6:00.